Hi there, Andrew Lessman here. In this one, we're talking about weight loss. And earlier this month, we did a meal we did our Today Special on our secure meal replacement. But in terms of weight loss, there's just so many different things to focus upon. And for me, the most important things, it's what we eat. As great as our meal replacement, and the science on meal replacement is that meal replacements are the most effective tool we could all reach for and try to find in terms of weight loss. So if it's not mine, try to find someone's that might work for you. But the most important thing in terms of weight loss is what we're going to eat. And that's why meal replacements work, because they relate to what we eat. But when we're not having a meal replacement, we have to make healthy decisions in terms of what we put in our body. And I know I always try this time of year. It's a time of year where all of us are more receptive to change. And we tend to have resolutions most frequently about weight loss. As a country, we're more overweight than ever. Even though for decades I've heard the experts say, well, it's gotten so bad, it can't get any worse. And I've heard that for decades. And it's only continued to get worse. About 40% of Americans are now obese. And then when you add those Americans that are overweight, we start approaching 75% of the American population that's overweight or obese, which is a frightening number beyond the impact it has on our individual lives, the collective impact it has on our society, on our economy, on healthcare, because the lion's share of our healthcare budget is going to be dealing with all of us aging and being overweight or obese. So I say the most patriotic decision we could make in this country is to achieve our ideal weight. It would dramatically reduce the trillions of dollars we spend on healthcare. It would probably eliminate one of those trillions of dollars. That I think we spend probably practically $3 trillion on healthcare in this country. That's not 3 billion. That's 3 trillion. That's 3,000 million or 3 million million. It's just a staggering number that we spend on healthcare, on drugs, on medical care, on surgeries and procedures. It's and even things, whether we realize it or not, even one of the most significant risk factors for cancer. Of course, we know about, you know, lung cancer and smoking and things like that. But one of the significant risk factors for just cancer in general is overweight and obesity. So there's so much, and obviously we know overweight and obesity is probably the principal risk of heart disease. It contributes to type 2 diabetes. It contributes to hypertension, high blood pressure. Go down the list, it's a major contributing factor to joint replacement and things like that. So to the extent we can, and this wasn't designed to being an alarmist video, it's maybe to try to underscore all the benefits that are to be derived. And those benefits are longer, healthier, happier lives. So whatever we can do, it's important to make that effort, both on an individual basis and in terms of the benefits to our society. We all hear talk about healthcare and all the things that have been going on in this country in terms of healthcare and health insurance and whatnot, but the most economical steps we could all take as a country and as individuals is to just find ourselves at our ideal weight. We obviously know that not smoking is a good idea and not drinking to excess is a good idea, but simply being at our ideal weight is just a dramatic benefit that we could all embrace, and it just results in hundreds of billions of dollars, a trillion dollars or more in savings annually. If our country could achieve the body composition that we had just when I was a little kid, it probably would save $1 trillion a year, which is a staggering amount of money. Healthcare for the entire country when I was a little kid wasn't even a fraction of that number that we would save. So it's great opportunities for all of us. Hopefully we take advantage of them. What I wanted to talk about are the cookbooks that Muriel and I have done. And the most important cookbooks, certainly our secure meal replacement is great if you're looking for a structured meal replacement. But if you're looking for an opportunity to have some recipes that you could fall in love with that provide healthy eating structure, then we have our soup cookbook, our healthy soup cookbook. We have our veggie cookbook. We have our everyday eating cookbook. And this is how we eat. I happen to be someone who, I love food. And I eat a lot of food. But because I'm active, and because the foods that I eat a lot of are not all that calorically dense, that I'm someone who never, you know, I'll eat anything other than eating fast food. And I've been that way for probably over 40 years. That I think, unfortunately, that a lot of people in our country, unfortunately, that's a staple of their diet. Whether it's going to be things like Big Macs and quarter pounders and fried chicken and things like that and French fries. The most popular vegetable, and it's not even a vegetable in our country, is the French fry. We've got to rediscover things like asparagus. And if you read the research on asparagus and health and the association of foods like asparagus or broccoli or cauliflower and kale with disease risk reduction, and you would only want to eat these foods and incorporate them in your diet as frequently as possible. That's what Muriel has done in her cookbooks. I'm someone who I only like food that tastes good. I don't care if it's healthy. It has to be healthy and taste good for me to enjoy eating it. So then I'm happy that it's healthy, but it needs to taste good. And whether it's the soups, whether it's the salads and things in the veggie cookbook, or whether it's the everyday eating that covers everything from the chicken we have at home, the fish, to the soups and veggies and things like that we frequently consume. Those are, really, that's the keys to the kingdom. If you just can pick up a few recipes there, and we give away these books. The price of these books is now less than we used to charge for their shipping when we introduced these books a few years ago. So it's an opportunity to get these books really affordably. And again, if you are overweight, if you are obese, it's not your fault, first of all. We like to blame our parents for lots of things, but we can blame our parents and our ancestors for our being overweight and obese, and you could have the absolute weight of all the science on your side when you do that. Because the fact that we arrive here today the way we are because of our ancestors. We were designed to thrive and to survive, really survive, in a world of scarcity, in a world where starvation was our number one risk. So if you went back to, say, World War I 100 years ago, virtually no one was obese, and very few people were overweight. But if you now look at the world we live in today, because we live in a world of abundance, and an abundance not just of food everywhere, but foods that have been designed to appeal to our lower senses, foods that are fatty and sweet and just, unfortunately, not a nutritious combination, but a calorically dense combination. So again, we were designed to thrive in a world of scarcity. So our taste buds, our palate, our behaviors, our neurology, we seek an abundance of those rich calories. We seek salty foods too. So we seek things that are not in our best interests because starvation was the greatest risk. So if starvation's the greatest risk, then guess what? Your taste buds are designed to identify the richest source of calories. And not only would you eat what you needed, you'd eat more than you needed because you never knew when you get to eat again. So that's the blueprint that in this day of abundance, we all still possess. My mobile phone is right next to me. On my mobile phone, not only could I make a phone call, as we always could for the last decade or so, to get food delivered, I could go to thousands of websites and just with a few clicks have food delivered. So it's no effort to have the least healthy things delivered to us. And unfortunately, the most available are often the least healthy. So we have to overcome what has become the status quo. We know what our genetics are. I mean, our meal replacement was designed, oddly enough, designed to taste like a high-calorie milkshake, because that's what our taste buds, that's what our palates, our neurology needs to feel satisfied. But these cookbooks were designed to deliver delicious, rich, healthy foods. And just as they say, it takes two or three weeks for a habit of exercise to become part of you, such that you really don't need to think about it after a while. The same thing applies to exercise. Same thing applies to a healthy diet, and that your palate changes, your taste buds change, and they become more receptive to foods that are not, that are much more subtle. So the way Murali has arranged this cookbook, it's rich, it's delicious, it caters to my, or panders to my need for a rich, tasty food, but it's healthy and it's low calorie. Just the soups, at any one time in our refrigerator, we probably have 24 little 8-ounce glass bowls of our asparagus soup, the split pea soup, and the sweet pea soup. And those are my snacks throughout the day. This time of year especially, our turkey chili, or sometimes we make the chili without turkey. It's so rich with all the beans and legumes, it's delicious. And just those soups alone are my secret to weight loss. So there are all sorts of opportunities available to us to make better decisions. Hopefully these books, they're literally a shipping charge to get them to you. And they're free shipping and handling, obviously. So it's an opportunity to make a profound difference. Knowledge is the key. Knowledge is king. That's our opportunity to make a difference. And if you could find, just in the veggie cookbook, the soup cookbook, the everyday eating cookbook, if you could just find a few recipes, that could be the difference between your weighing the same in July as you weigh today, or you could weigh 25, 30 pounds less. That's an opportunity that we all have in front of us, and it's not about going crazy with exercise. It's not about going crazy with the diet. It's just about making the small modifications that gives our body a chance to start getting some traction and some positive momentum. And once that starts, those habits become behaviors, and then just as it's hard to change bad behaviors, it becomes hard to change the positive behaviors. So hopefully that's what things like our secure meal replacement, our energy and fat metabolism factors, our acetyl L-carnitine. These are tools on a molecular, on a cellular level that can assist you. But the real power when it comes to weight loss, the real power is you. It's making that decision, deciding that your health, your well-being, the people you love, that you're all important enough to enjoy this benefit. And it's something that has to be with you every moment of the day, because it's a decision that needs to be made and remade constantly through the day. And so we're there for you. We have an 800 number. You could always call us. And just as we can inform you about our products, we're just as happy to inform you about healthy eating decisions and things like that. And if they can't give you an answer in my call center or my company, then I'll be sure to do so. You just call us at 800-800-FREE. That's 800-800-3733. And it is free. The advice is free. We're always there to help you, to help explain what the cookbook might discuss. And all the recipes, of course, in the cookbook. Most cookbooks, they're like big secrets. The recipes in our cookbook, you see all the calories, the carb content, the sugar content, the protein content, the nutrient content. You need to know what you're eating if you're going to be an informed consumer and if you're going to be effective and successful at weight loss and good health. And that's what all our cookbooks provide, is more information than you'd even get on a food label, which no other cookbook that I've seen does that, because we really want you to succeed. So from Muriel and from me to you, we make these books ridiculously affordable because they're the most important thing anyone can do in terms of their good health. I make the best vitamins in the world. They don't come close to the importance of what you eat on a daily basis. So to the extent we could help you eat better, then that is far more important than any supplement I can ever make. So I encourage you to take advantage of these books and to take advantage of making good decisions on your part, because you hold the keys to the kingdom. As they say, God takes care of those who take care of themselves. This is an opportunity for all of us to take care of ourselves.